Jack Elias, world famous historian, and this is Crime in Melbourne. Melbourne is a city of great culture and diversity, but it was here 150 years ago when Melbourne changed. But was it for the good? That's why I'm here to find out.
I have studied crime all over the world for 50 years, but here in Melbourne, I have come to see what influenced crime in the mid to late 19th century and how it impacted the 1920s and the future today.
Today, crime in Melbourne is prominent, from low-end petty crime to high-end drug trade. But what influenced this crime? That's why we need to dive into the past to find the answer.
When gold was first discovered in Victoria in the 1850s, the population grew rapidly. It went from 75,000 to 550,000 people. That's a staggering 475,000 more people. This led to more crimes, and as a result, law and order was harder to maintain. This also caused the overcrowding of the old Melbourne jail within 5 years of its opening. The gold rush had also brought wealth to the state, resulting in the expansion of Melbourne. I have come to the old Melbourne jail, a significant part of Melbourne's history. Between 1845 and 1929, this site has been the home of many executions and the imprisonment of many notorious criminals, including Melbourne's 1900s gangster, Squizzy Taylor.
So this is what it would be like being one of these jail cells. You can see it's really small, about 5 meters by like one. And at the start of, in the first cell block, they were known for it being overcrowded, small, tight spaces with poor sanitation and horrible living conditions, as you can see.
This is the watchtower, located next to the old Melbourne jail, where people who did low-end crime stayed here from anywhere between overnight and a month. Each holding cell can hold about 12 people in it. Standing here, I can really feel what it would be like to be locked up. This holding cell is especially significant because Squizzy Taylor was once put in this very cell. But one night, Squizzy Taylor ripped a metal hinge off the shower and scooped out a hole through the roof by standing on the shoulders of 8 people. He then managed to get into the magistrate's court on the other side of the wall and escape through the front door. But who was Squizzy Taylor? Well, let's dive into his early life.
I am standing on the streets of Richmond, and back in the late 19th century, this was home to the notorious criminal Joseph Leslie Taylor, also known as Squizzy Taylor. It was on these streets that Squizzy lived, committed crimes, and hid from the police. He was born in Brighton in 1888, and at an early age moved to Richmond, which at the time was a poor working class suburb. When Squizzy was a teenager, his father died. As a result, he resorted into committing petty crimes like theft. This was the beginning of his criminal life, which spanned 25 years.
Squizzy was a notorious gang lord and was the mastermind behind his gang operations. Throughout his criminal career, many charges laid on him, like murder, were withdrawn, leading to reduced jail sentences. It is believed that Squizzy used a couple of methods to escape these charges, including jury fixing and witness intimidation.
This is believed to be the location where Squizzy Taylor once hid in the 1920s. It was in this property that he ran a legal gambling house. It is also the location of a secret tunnel that would head in that direction, where he would get into another sequence. He also used to write letters to the Herald Sun in places like these.
Due to Squizzy's popularity, other gangs like the Fitzroy gang tried to take him down. Squizzy's gang also started to break down when some members doubted his actions. This was the beginning of his downfall and led to his death.
I am standing here at Barclay Street, Carlton, and it was here on the 27th of October 1927 that Squizzy Taylor died. He went to visit Snowy Cutmore, a rival of his that was ill. A gunfight followed.
Thank you.
Cutmore died and Squizzy was severely injured. Squizzy later passed away at St. Vincent's Hospital.
Throughout my journey in Melbourne, I have explored the impact that crime during the late 19th century and the early 20th century has had on present-day Melbourne. It was due to the gold rush that crime in Melbourne skyrocketed. Key buildings from that era, such as the Old Melbourne Jail, have also shaped Melbourne's history. Infamous criminals like Squizzy Taylor have also left a lasting legacy that has now become an important part of Melbourne's past. I am Jacques Elias, and this was Crime in Melbourne.
So when you're caught in a landslide, I'll be there for you, I'll be there for you. And in the rain, give you sunshine. I'll be there for you, I'll be there for you. And every time that you're lonely, and every time that you feel alone, you should know I'll be there for you, I'll be there for you, I'll be there for you, you know. I'll be there for you, I'll be there for you, I'll be there for you, you know. I'll be there for you, I'll be there for you, I'll be there for you, you know. Oh, I'll be there for you, I'll be there for you, I'll be there for you, you know. And every time that you're lonely, and every time that you're feeling low, you should know I'll be there for you, I'll be there for you, I'll be there for you, you know.